The U.S. has been occupying portions of Syria illegally since 2011. They've killed thousands and thousands of Syrians, as opposed to the 5,000 civilian deaths on both sides in Ukraine since February that these newspapers call a Holocaust and genocide. And on top of all of that, they've used it as a base for jihadis, for terrorists, for the entire region operating out of there. The United States, its own law, makes it illegal to provide aid or other comfort to terrorists. And in fact, a lawyer friend of mine ended up doing 4 years in federal prison because she held a press conference that they decided was support. Certainly arming, training, providing air support and logistical information and command and control to an army of terrorists violates that law, which means that there are senior government officials who make policy and who execute orders on behalf of the United States who are committing crimes under U.S. law that need to be prosecuted by the U.S. Department of Justice if they're not prosecuted in an international forum. And if that doesn't happen, the one thing people in the United States can do is force it to happen.
Okay, thank you so much for that. Mohammed Ali in Damascus, Don DeBar in Westchester, New York.